Council, this is going to be brief, but we want to keep you up to date as we move through this process. We're getting near the end of the PPEA process. I want to remind you that we had a conceptual phase on the unsolicited PPEA proposal that we received from SB Ballard. We received solicited and received competing proposals from two teams. And
can you give like a 2-second background for the benefit of the students that are here? Sure. On the PPEA?
Absolutely.
So they kind of understand what we're talking about?
Absolutely. As a reminder, this is a procurement method essentially for construction of schools that the state allows us under the Public Private Education Act to work under a process that's defined by the state and mirrored in our local codes for how we select a contractor, a development partner for a package of facilities. This happens to be a package of five schools that was authorized by City Council and for funding for last year. And so what we received from a developer was an unsolicited proposal. And again, this process that the state has established allows us to work through that and essentially work in what you would call similar to a design build type of environment, as opposed to a design bid build environment for procurement. So where we are now is we have reviewed and analyzed all of the proposals from the three teams, and we have not eliminated any of the teams. They all were, as I mentioned before, were strong packages. However, we have decided to go ahead and move forward and start negotiations with SB Ballard Construction Company, who, yes, was the unsolicited proposer. When we did the solicitations, the proposals did evolve even from SB Ballard, and that's where we were able to look at apples and apples comparisons and really have good interviews and understandings for what were the costs, what was their design approaches, what experience did they bring with their team to the table. And so we feel that in SB Ballard Construction, we have a strong partner that can give us a great product for these 21st century facilities.
You keep on saying we, but can you define who the we is?
Because
people think that it was City Council.
It is
Ballard.
At this point, it is the PPEA review team made up of executive staff of the city administration and the school system. The City Council will be receiving docketed in April if negotiations go well and we get to the point where we will bring you an interim agreement that would approve us working through an interim phase with the developer. And what the interim agreement will have is agreements and funding for conceptual design up to 30% for construction drawings, required public engagement workshops, some site work analysis, and then we are also going to recommend that the Campus Stella demolition actually occur in the interim period. What all that does is gives us information to inform and make decisions about what the final conceptual designs can be for the five schools, that then we can negotiate a final guaranteed maximum price from the proposer. And that would come back to council at that point, which we believe will take 2 to 6 months to bring a final comprehensive agreement for council approval on what the final package is. That's when you'll see the dollar amount that the five schools cost X, based on this conceptual design input on the public engagement and input from the communities. And again, we believe that it's advantageous to get some of this work done in the interim agreement.
You said April would be probably the approval of the interim agreement.
Correct.
The next phase is public engagement. What is the timeline for the public engagement? Because I think that's where there's controversy that's happening right now with accusations and things that this is being done closed. I found that if you explain it to the public why this has all happened, why there's a PPEA, the process that has to be followed, it takes away some of the controversy. But the public truly and really wants to know when they're going to have an opportunity where these schools are impacting and other people want to be involved in it, when they can have those discussions. That's where I'm hearing this is. And if we know when this is going to fall, then we should start picking dates right now and putting out where these are going to be and when they're going to be, and not wait 2 weeks before the meeting to advertise it, because that's, I don't know if anybody agrees with me, but that's what I'm hearing from the community.
No, I agree. And, you know, there is this, people are sending a message that somehow all five of these schools are going to be sort of cookie cutter renditions.
Right.
We're just going to, you know, and
it's not.
We agree, and we are.
Okay.
We're doing that.
Okay.
I will tell you, there is a significant impetus for us to get Campus Stella done, particularly because the students are out of the school. And so we have that. It's the first school that we are going to build. And so as much as possible, we're fast-tracking that now.
Didn't all the community conversations already kind of happen with Campus Stella?
No.
More than
no.
any other?
No.
It
no.
did it?
No.
No.
Not
I thought
all
that's how it was decided that it
no,
was
in
a
fact,
STEM
we had
school.
Southside Task Force this morning. And
okay.
Really got into
in
that.
Terms of the there was front side conversations, but in terms of the or back side yeah. conversations, we'll have a reading, but then there's still more conversation to be had in terms of what the school's going to look like, what the programming is going to be.
Right.
It's going to be a joint effort between the city and the schools to make sure that they get that we get the best school possible, especially since it's a STEM school. Over in Camp Stella. So, yeah, we're going to go back to them.
So we expect Camp Stella to kick off April, May, and then they would sequentially follow through the summer and realistically wrap it up by the end of the
and
summer.
We'll probably learn something at every one of those.
Exactly.
I mean, just how the building sits on the site.
Right.
You know, where the drop-offs are. I mean, all of that stuff will be
right.
very important.
Right. And we will plan to use a classic charrette type of process for these workshops. You know, we start with the concepts. Let everybody come, you know, give feedback, take the feedback, massage the concepts, come back and you know, respond that did we hear you, yes or no, validate that, and then move forward from there. So that's where we are. And we believe that really, again, what you're going to start to see is more incremental short milestones that are coming up. So, it's not going to be just one school. Camp Stella's can start to take the lead after you pass the interim agreement. That will kick it off, and then you're gonna have multiple layers, because it's all kind of layered on top of when you're in design, when you're in public engagement. Are we ready? Are we starting to get to something close to a number that we can get to that guarantee maximum price?
Your Honor, I don't know whether this was Tommy was talking about or not, but the individuals who believe that there's some architectural integrity in Larchmont and Ocean View. When will they get their chance?
When we have the workshops.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. So we'll be ready to start to, you know, settle on a date. We're working with the school system. We need to work with the council and everyone. You know, we need several input on to settle on those. But we believe that, again, Camp Stella will kick it off, and then
sure.
we'll start to flow through the summer.
So the public engagement workshops are to get what from the public, not necessarily designed, because when they submit their packages, the cost of this is around certain designs and specs, correct? There can only be so many changes with that. Is it more about programming of what's going to happen in those buildings?
It's
and maybe some minor things, like, for example, all these school buildings should be equipped to handle active shooter situations, that you can shut down the front office. And that's it. If we're going to build new elementary schools, we need to build them to prepare for active shooters. But, I mean,
it's a combination of all those.
We don't need to build up the public's expectation that they're going to be able to change the designs of these schools when we already know that there are specs already done for. There's a general
understanding. We have a baseline and some concepts that can
right.
be used within the allocations that we have. They can be completely changed from what we have, yes.
Okay.
The opportunity's there. It's all about what are you willing to, you know, to change.
Okay.
The key is, in the beginning, and that's what we're already working on. We spent 16 hours last week working on programming and an understanding of what does the school system need for size of classrooms, what does the STEM program need, the extra space or the breakout space. We're working through that. What's the state standard? What are the Title I standards that we need per pupil per classroom? So a lot of that's being done on the front end to understand, okay, what's the basic program for 1,100 students for Campus Stella? What do we need for that? It just as a bare requirement, just in numbers for a facility. and how it all aligns, then it comes in with the professional input about, well, obviously, curriculum and education happens in one wing. You want multipurpose in another wing. You want administration, and then you want security parameters that lay over all that. That builds in to then bring a concept. And then there's lots of tweaks and changes that can be made with an understanding of what's the basic cost for all that.
Okay, so now is the time for your staff to sit down with the press and explain to them what this process is, because there are questions being asked because nobody understands this process. We've discussed it once, but there's a lot of new information that I found out today about this process, and that's great. I think there's some people that know more than other people, and it's your staff. Your staff knows this. So how do we get this out to the public so that it looks, you know, and we have that the public understands this process? It's not, it hasn't been the most transparent to a fault. It's not our fault, though. Right. It's just okay. Because people don't understand how this went about, the process. Sure. So we need to educate the public on that and make sure they understand where this is going from here. And we have not done a good job at that.
Sure. It's also a big ticket item, too. I mean, so, you know, they would want to know. I mean, we're talking, I think, when you roll it all up, it was like $140 million in our budget. I don't know if that's the right figure or not. Correct. It was, but anyway, it's a big number.
Yes, it is.
I mean, when you put all these schools together.
Yes.
Okay. Maybe weekly updates on the city's webpage might be helpful. An outline or something on the city's webpage might be helpful as to the process from start to finish and where it is. I think one of the issues that does come into play with that is when you start talking about what's going to happen and you give dates, people get those dates stuck in their heads. And that can be problematic because things are fluid and they change. But some kind of update that, even if it's abroad in the next 2 to 3 months, sure, we can expect this, or in the next 4 to 5 months, we can expect that. And that way it gives you something to refer people back to on the website that they can, and it also gives us an opportunity to tell our story. I still maintain that we can't tell our story if we don't buy ink by the barrel, and we don't buy ink by the barrel, but we do have a website. And so we can use that to tell the story that we want to tell and put the information up there and then put it in a place where people can easily find it. They don't have to go digging for it.
I also want to thank you, Ron and Marcus. I mean, you know, we came into a situation where it looked like these capital construction costs, like we didn't have a handle on them at all for all of these schools, but you guys have managed to get a handle on it. And, I mean, that's good. That's good for the taxpayer as well. So, thank you.
And then, Mayor, and Council, the last update we have is from Jim Reddick.